Hello students, today we will discuss on our topic translation. Translation, which is also a step of central dogma. We know that in central dogma, coding information which are live on DNA are converted into protein. So from DNA to production of protein is known as central dogma. This process is takes place in three steps, that are replication, transcription and translation. In replication, DNA form from DNA. The formation of DNA from DNA, this process is known as replication, and RNA form from DNA. So formation of RNA from DNA, this process is known as transcription. And coding information which are live on RNA are converted into protein. So formation of protein from RNA, this process is known as translation. So we will discuss on this step, translation. In translation, protein synthesis occur in cytoplasm, because protein synthesis catalyzed by the cell organelle ribosome, and ribosome lie in cytoplasm. So protein synthesis or translation is takes place in cytoplasm. Here we can see that ribosome, there are two types, 70S and 80S. 70S of ribosome are found in prokaryotes, while 80S type of ribosome are found in eukaryotes. Here we can see that ribosome have two subunits, a larger subunit and a small subunit. Here in prokaryotes, a small subunit of 30S and large subunit of 50S. While in eukaryotes, a small subunit of 40S and a large subunit of 60S. So protein synthesis is catalyzed by ribosome. So ribosome is also known as factory of protein synthesis. So translation is complete within three steps. So we discuss about translation in three steps. So first of all, we discuss on initiation, after that elongation, and after that termination. So initiation, elongation and termination, these are three steps by which a translation process is completed into cytoplasm. So first of all, in initiation, here we can see that in initiation stage, amylase is activated. After amylase activation, charging of tRNA is also occur in initiation step. Here we can see that activation of amino acid, in which amino acid by the use of ATP convert into activated amino acid, and this after that activated amino acid also bind tRNA by the use of another ATP and convert into activated tRNA. This process is catalyzed by an enzyme, that is amino acid synthetase, and this process is known as charging of tRNA or aminoacylation of tRNA. So these are belong to initiation. After that, mRNA bind to a small subunit of ribosome, and a small subunit of ribosome get slide on mRNA, where a small subunit of ribosome will recognize an initiator codon where protein synthesis takes place. So after sliding, a small subunit of ribosome come in contact with initiator codon AUG, and a small subunit of ribosome attached to AUG, locating location on mRNA. After that, a large subunit of ribosome combined to small subunit of ribosome, and thus here start of protein takes place. So these all steps are take place in first step of translation, which is known as initiation. So after initiation, this complex between mRNA and ribosome, the ribosome move on mRNA codon by codon, and after that amino acid added amino acid one by one, and so thus a new polypeptide form is formed, and this process is known as elongation. So in elongation process of translation, here we can see that in this process ribosome move on mRNA codon by codon, and by this, when ribosome move on mRNA by the coding information like mRNA, complementary tRNA or charged tRNA according to codon, complementary anticodon tRNA will come here and bind to AUG, where protein synthesis is going to start. So first tRNA which is bind on P site, while another next tRNA which take participate in protein synthesis will bind to A site. So ribosome move on mRNA according to codon, complementary anticodon tRNA come and bind to A site, which is also known as acceptor site, and start to add amino acid bind to tRNA, get bind to another amino acid, and thus a polypeptide chain is synthesized. So in elongation, after initiation, ribosome move on mRNA codon to codon, and thus a newly polypeptide synthesis takes place, and amino acid added one by one. So in this elongation, protein synthesis move forward, and newly protein chain get formed. After this elongation, when ribosome moves on mRNA, at the end of this process, ribosome will meet to have a different type of codon, which is known as stop codon. Here we can see there are three stop codons in our living system. First UAG, second UCA, and third UAA. When ribosomes meet with these stop codon, the protein synthesis process is terminated. And so this step is known as termination. So when ribosome meet with this stop codon, then initiate to release the total complex. So after stop codon meet ribosome mRNA, detach automatically, and newly synthesized polypeptide detached from ribosome. Both the subunits of ribosome, small and large subunit, detached, and thus our termination process is occur. So thus a newly polypeptide chain removed from here, and after modification, this protein is used in your biological system in different metabolic reactions. So this is the translation. ट्रांसलेशन प्रोसेस विच टेक्स प्लेस इन साइटोप्लाज्म बाय दिस प्रोसेस कोडिंग इंफॉर्मेशन विच आर लाइव ऑन डीएनए कन्वर्ट इनटू प्रोटीन एंड सो दिस प्रोसेस ऑफ ट्रांसलेशन इज आल्सो नोन एज प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस. So this is all about translation or protein synthesis. Thank you.